Hi, folks, and welcome to What Says Here is almost live from the Castanet Club, an amazing web series that's coming your way. First of three shows of all sorts of things going on here at the Newcastle Museum. My name's Maynard. I used to be in the Castanet Club, and I'm wearing my glasses because I'm serious. This bit of paper's been given to me by the Lord Mayor of Newcastle to read, and if I don't, my rates are going to go up. Sucked in, Lord Mayor. I'm not even registered as a human in Newcastle. Anyway, on today's show, you're going to be seeing, oh man, all sorts of stuff. Viva Las Vegas performed in an interesting way from the Lairs, but let's get a bit of archival action going here. That's right, go all wavy and go through the years as we go back to 1988. And remember, I left the band in 1987, so that's when they got really good. This is from 1988 with the Medley Sisters doing The Devil Went Down to Georgia. So, you know, it's a bit, woohoo, it's a bit heretical here, but we're going to enjoy it. The Medley Sisters from the Castanet Club archives here at the Newcastle Museum.
But we have to raise the unfortunate and very sad and pathetic issue of professional rivalry. Even though I adore this woman as if she was my sister, in fact she is, she seems to find it difficult to accept that I am a superior musician. Silly, isn't it, really? So we're going to let you judge and just see who exactly you think is the better musician. It might seem a bit trivial, but it's very important to us. You ready?
Ready, Doris.
Three, four. In this song, I feature as the devil! Yeah! The devil came down to Georgia. She was looking for a soul to steal. I was in a bind because I was way behind, but I was willing to make a deal. When I came across this young girl playing on the fiddle and playing it hot, the devil jumped up on a marker stump. I said, girl, let me tell you what.
Yeah, what, Doris?
Oh, don't you speak to me in that sullen tone of voice. I'll tell you what. I guess you didn't know it, girl, but, well, I'm a musician too. And if you'd care to take a dare, I'll make a bet with you. You play pretty good fiddle, girl, but give old Doris her due. I'll bet a fiddle of gold against your soul because I think I'm better than you. Like I know it.
So I said, devil, my name's Kid, and it might be a sin, but I'll take your bet you're gonna regret because I'm the best there's ever been.
What's there about that?
Kid, you rosin up your bow and play your fiddle hard because hell's broke loose in Georgia and the devil deals the cards. And if you win, you'll get this shiny fiddle made of gold. But if you lose, the devil gets your soul.
Opened up her clay saying, this'll be a breeze. Fire flew from her fingertips as she ran them across the keys. Yeah! Up the accordion, up with air, and it made an evil hiss. A band of demons joined in, and it sounded a bit like this.
Oh, when she'd finished, I exclaimed, you're pretty hot, I guess. But you just sit down over there and I'll show you who's the best. And we sang, fire in the mountain, run, girls, run. Devil's in the house of the rising sun. Chicken in the bread pan, picking out gold. Granny, is it all bad? No, China. Once you feel right, Moll, I'm the best there's ever been.
Fire on the mountain, run, girls, run. Got even with her.
Devil's in the house of the rising sun.
Chicken in the bread pan, picking up dough.
granny, does it up bat, no John, no. Got it!
There's people dangerously close to me. I know that's the case, and we have a geologist and a bartender. And they all work into a bar together, and they're going to make a... What we've got here? Catherine, what have we got here? But hi, Harry, how are you? How's Sprout
pretty
going?
Good. Sprout's going well, currently.
And I believe that you...
Down in COVID, but...
Yeah, well, yeah, exactly. How much catering do you think is going on at the moment? Not a lot, but Harry's ready to go when there is. Now, you're going to oversee what we do here, Catherine, and what the hell... Look, my favourite cocktail is the Tokyo Sandblaster, but it's currently illegal. What are we making here?
Crikey, that's an introduction. Well, we're going to get started on a castanet today, which is really exciting, and Harry's here to stop us getting a bit carried away. Now, as you said, Maynard, I am a scientist, and to be really intelligent as a scientist, we always apply our... intelligence glasses. Now, here we go. Oh, this wow. is mine. Now, I actually... Oh, no, Maynard, I've made some for you. Oh. Here we go. I have some for you right here. There we go.
Oh, wow.
So that will increase your intelligence 3,000%, and we can now say, hello, Dr. Maynard.
3,000.
There we go.
Great. Okay.
That's scientifically proven.
I've only got another 190 to go. I'm doing okay. This is cool.
Excellent. So the castanet is a special cocktail that was created by Sprout for this this event, and we're very excited to drink as many... No, we're very excited to show you how it's done. So I've actually brought... my own cup today, because this is absolutely, this is what you're going to need if you make one of these. No, don't worry, Harry, it's okay.
So, and you may be thinking, why a geologist making a cocktail? Because cocktails rock. That's what it is.
Oh,
so
very
go.
Good.
Yeah, bitch, you never heard that one. Yeah, now,
I love
okay,
it.
I'm gonna shut up and let you do the work.
So we've actually got three of these cocktail shakers, so we can all do it as we go. We are going to start with some creme de cacao. Now, obviously, castanets, it's got to be Lamington flavoured, right?
I would hope so. And it's Vok as well. Vok were very well known in the 70s and 80s for their top shelf stuff. And Parfait d'Amour was one they had, which was purple and smelled like Mortine fly spray.
Glad very, we're not using very, that
very
one
cool
today.
Yeah, yep.
So this one is actually made from the tears of Sydney Ciders who are currently stuck in lockdown. They can't come and see this wonderful exhibition, you see. There's 30 mils of that. So everybody, you're not going to do your own?
I'm going to let the person who is tertiary trained do this first.
Oh, no. But
and the one who is trained.
There's one for each of us.
Okay.
There we go.
Well.
Into your...
Do you want to add your ice first?
Oh,
good. See,
yeah, the person who knows what's...
This is why we've got Harry here, because he knows what he's doing, you see. We don't really know. So well, there we go. Let's add some ice. There we go.
Right. Wow.
There we go.
Isn't normally what happens at a party when someone says that, but anyway.
I don't know what sort of parties you go to.
Cook's Hill, 1985.
I'm a scientist. There we go. I'll pass you that one.
Right. And we put in... I'll let you go first, Harry,
meals.
So I know what to do after you've done this.
30 mils. That's the big end of one of these.
All right.
Excellent. And I can already smell that chocolate flavour coming off. Now, the science of alcohol is quite depressing. We are using class one carcinogens. So this is the equivalent of mustard gas or plutonium or arsenic. You know, just to really get the party going here.
Isn't,
you know, the
isn't coffee
is full
in
of
that
good
class?
News.
I thought coffee was in that class.
No.
We're called to the world. Oh, I thought that
coffee
and gravity were both in those classes. Right.
And then we have this one. This one is Chambord, which is, as you can see from the bottle, made from ground testicles.
Right.
Now, we have right. another.
Again, only of Sydney ciders who could not find a park. Oh.
I could have just poured that straight in there. You held that out.
Well.
You like that one. That's kind of like a raspberry flavour, that
oh,
one.
Oh, there you go, Harry.
There we go.
Thank you.
Hey, Harry, as a bartender, you know, obviously a spill will happen from time to time. Do you find the chucks or the tea towel is the best thing to be using in that situation?
Both work just as well.
Yeah, whatever's closest
depends.
To you.
Yeah.
I just thought I'd mention that just in case there's a spill. Just thought, because we do have Castanet Club tea towels on sale here at the at Newcastle Museum, you see? Right.
All right, and we have 30 mils of the milk as well.
So okay.
Just so you can claim that it's slightly healthy.
Right, now yes. Milk, that's down in the class two carcinogen, isn't it?
It's no, milk's good for you.
Oh, is it? Okay, just checking. Sure, I have some in the fridge somewhere up the back.
This one we've got coconut cream, which is, again, not good for you. So.
No, I think it's the highly saturated
it
fat.
That's right.
It's a vegetable oil, but it's not a good one.
Oh, now that's interesting thought.
Because it would be a highly saturated vegetable oil.
Is a coconut a vegetable or a fruit or a nut? What do you think, Harry?
I have no idea. It's got nut in the name.
It does.
Yes, that's right. That's the giveaway.
It's actually a fibrous one-seeded drupe.
Right.
Which is a fruit.
Yes.
So there you go.
Don't hear that very often in a sentence at the museum, but if you stay
here long
enough.
Oh, you do when I'm working here.
Oh, okay. Right. Wow.
There we go. And this is the one we have 45 mils of, so that's filling up each end. Now, there are some lumps in that, but that's okay.
Well, I'll pass this off to the expert to have a go at that one. He's trained in the use of coconut milk.
Now, coconut cream is, it separates the fat from the water very, very quickly. So you'll find when you buy that in a can like that, you'll get lumps, they're okay. So it's all fine if a lump goes in,
right.
That's all good. Here, there's plenty of these.
Right. And would you normally find this in igneous rocks or not?
Coconut, very rare. I would be a little concerned, actually, if you did find one.
That would be an undiscovered object. And look, might I just say, this is a recreation of a share house in the 80s in Newcastle in Cook's Hill. And everything's stuck down, very much the same as an actual excavator. And the chair, lean forward for a moment, we just want to see the towel. See, a towel on the back of that chair, you're thinking, why would you have a towel like that in a share house? Two reasons. They could have just come back from the beach and it could be drying, or that chair is so old, it is not medically safe for skin to ever contact that. And no matter how dirty your towel is, it's going to be cleaner than the chair. But you're safe there. Don't worry, there's a towel in there.
Excellent.
Right, okay.
Excellent.
Just a bit of an explanation to our setting here that looks like an old episode of Number 96. Anyway, that's another story. Wait.
Now we're reaching Harry's area of expertise because the idea is to rim the glasses with coconut. So we have a plate of dried ground coconut here. And Harry, if you want to add, there we go, we've got a bowl of water.
Yep,
bowl. Pop that on the side.
Good
there we go, just a bowl. We'll pop in some milk perhaps. Just something to make the coconut stick to the rim of the glass.
Ah, yes. Always moisten the rim of your glass, people. Again, something you don't normally hear in a museum.
All right, go for it, Harry.
Harry.
If you can make that coconut stick.
Now, there's
the
school of thought. You either do it in the one go there, like Harry's going to do, or you do it circularly. But I want to know how the professional. He's doing it in the one go version. Look at that.
Nice.
This is great.
Oh, that's good. That's really good. All right.
Pretty good,
well,
Harry.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Now, I'm trying not to knock over anything here. So, can we shake this stuff yet?
Yep, shake it up.
Okay, rightio. Now, it's important that you maintain the seal on this when you're doing this.
Yeah.
And you shake it very carefully. Note I'm doing side to side instead of up and down. I've been known for that. But here we go.
Shaking it all over the place.
Here we go. how have the sedimentary rocks been going at Seaham lately? Is that still the place to go for sedimentary rocks in the Hunter Valley or not?
Oh, look, the Hunter Valley, we're talking full sedimentary rocks. That's all we've got, sedimentary rocks.
Oh, Jesus. don't we have a lava flow somewhere?
We do have a few. We have a few.
Hmm. Have we got any interesting geographical rocks at any sea vents that go out?
All rocks.
Like in Hawaii.
All rocks are interesting, Maynard. All rocks are interesting.
Oh, but those vents in Hawaii are really interesting. I thought we might have something
like
that.
Have you got rock envy?
No, I'm just trying to talk geology stuff, you know? Look, see, the thing is, we've got an active bartender here, so at like 4 a.m, you could have 10 of these and he'd be able to talk your sedimentary rocks and you didn't know what they were talking about. Right, so how do we put, right, okay. Thanks for doing the glass.
Thank you, Harry,
there, Harry.
For the glasses.
And I'll let you pour so I can see how this action's going.
Oh, yes.
Look at this.
We should have got Harry to pour first.
That's pretty good.
Very nice.
Pretty good. So if one was on in a share house in the 80s and trying to make this would probably be the combined income of all four people to buy these
yes,
ingredients.
Absolutely.
What's it work at these days? Because I imagine in a proper bar, like you might bump into Harry at, it would be at least a...
I'm quite sure.
Well, in Sydney, you'd probably have to mortgage your house if you actually owned one.
Absolutely.
Which is probably very unlikely. But there we go. Well, now what do we do now? Is this the...
Now, there's a bit of decoration on the top, so...
Cool, a Hawaiian shirt.
We're going to... Absolutely, we're going to grate some chocolate. There you are, I'll let you do the fancy way. Right. Harry, you and I can be lazy-ass cheaters, and we can just sprinkle flake on the top of ours.
Right, but mine goes like this,
do the hard work.
Right, okay. You can also use tuna in this cocktail if you like, but I wouldn't recommend it.
Very healthy, though.
Ah, yes, it just comes out of the one tin.
Increase the healthiness.
Go. Okay, give it a go there with the flake.
Pass it to the chocolate expert.
There we go.
Should I just grate the chocolate?
Yes.
There we go.
Right, see.
All right, now we could probably take off our glasses for this point if you like.
Oh, yeah, the intelligence is going to go down without the glasses coming off, let me tell you. I do quite
well,
like this.
Well, the alcohol will also help with the intelligence going down as
right.
well.
Now, right, okay, wow. See, there you go. Right, so do we get to drink it now?
Oh, no. The first thing with any tasting is you must smell, inhale it. And I'm getting notes of coconut and jam with a high note of diabetes on this one. What are you getting?
How many years did you go to uni? That's pretty good. I think that's pretty good. Yeah, give it a go there. So we get notes of... Oh, yeah. Look, the diabetes is the top note. I think you'll find that that's what's there. Okay, well, I'll give it a bit of a go. Let's have a
drink. The Castanets.
To the Castanet Club. The Castanets are dead. Long live the Castanet Club. Now, we're going to have some amazing stuff here from the Lairs performing their version of Viva Las Vegas. This version of this turned up in the Castanet Club movie, which is pretty good. You should check that out yourself. But the Lairs are going to knock it out of the park now with a movie that starred Anne Margaret and a particularly pelvisy Elvisy. So enjoy the Lairs performing almost live at the Castanet Club, Viva Las Vegas. I think it's French.
Soul on fire. There's a whole lot of money and it's ready to burn. So get those stakes up high. Well, there's a thousand pretty women just waiting out there, and they're all living devil may care. And I'm just a devil with love to spare. So Viva Las Vegas, Viva Las Vegas. Well, how I wish that there were more. Vegas with your neon lights flashing and your one-up and it's crashing all your hopes down the drain. Viva Las Vegas, turn a day into nighttime, turn a night into daytime. If you've seen it once, you'll never be the same again. I wanna keep on the run, I'm gonna have me some fun. If it cost me my very last dime, and if I wind up broke, then I'll always remember that I had swing time. Well, I'm gonna give it everything I've got. Lady luck, let the dice run hot. I wanna shoot the seven on every shot. So Viva Las Vegas, Viva Las Vegas, Viva, Viva Las Vegas.
What a show, people. What a show. You've seen so much stuff. You've seen alcohol. You've been seeing people sitting on couches. You've seen Viva Las Vegas, which may be French or not. Don't hold me to that. But you've got to go now. We'll be back in a month's time with almost the Castanet Club. I'm going to stay right here till then. Oh, come on. Turn the lights back on.